Have you ever seen a really cool feature request for Godot and wished you could check it out? So here's a way not many people know about that allows anyone to try unreleased features of Godot. I'm not talking about beta features, but in-development features that have not yet been merged into Godot. With this, you can even take advantage of some quality of life features to help you out. For example, here is one that creates path 3D points snapped to colliders. You can use this build to create your paths much more easily and then go back to the normal editor. So, how can you use and test these features? First, let's go to Godot's official GitHub page. This is where all the Godot's code is hosted. And if you go to the actions, we can see what is called GitHub Actions. Each time an update request is pushed to Godot, an action is created to test the code and make sure everything is okay. But the great thing about this is that it also creates a fully working build of Godot that you can download and use. So, to get the latest version of Godot, you can click on the OK icon of the passing test and click on any of the listed tests. From here, go to Summary over to the right and scroll down to the artifacts where you can download the Godot build of your OS. You just need to be logged in your free GitHub account to see the download button. If you don't see the icon in the latest update here, you can click on commits to get a full list of updates and look for the first update message that has tests pass mark. Click on it, and then it's just the same as before. Go to Summary and download the Godot from the artifacts. Then you can just use this Godot and it's done. But this is only slightly useful. The official dev and beta releases you can get on the official site are usually only a few weeks behind the code here. So let's see how we can check out some of the in-development features. Let's go ahead and click the pull request page. A great way to know about some good features is to filter by number of comments or likes. Those are generally highly requested features and improve a lot of things. From here, you can click on the checkmark and go to download the artifacts. And if you are inside the feature post to get more information, you can find the test at the very bottom. Just expand the test section and go to details. But anyways, let's check out this cool feature. It adds the ability to expose nodes from instanced scenes, which is really useful. For example, normally, you would need to enable editable children to see the hat mount position inside the model and put the hat inside there. But besides having to expose the whole scene, it can make your scene tree very cluttered for more complex objects. With this feature, you can select the specific nodes inside the scene and tag them as exposed, giving them this new icon. And now, the model instance will always display this node. So we can just put the hat there with no extra steps. And notice that the hat mount actual parent is hidden, as we don't care about that. This is also extremely useful for UI nodes, where you can only expose the containers that differ from one another. So we don't need to see all those extra top containers we don't care about. Now the main scene tree is cleaner and easier to look at. Very useful. But speaking of editable children, there is a much needed feature that has been in development for a while. Applying changes to editable children. So you don't need to redo the changes inside the original scene. But you see, this feature is a bit stuck. It has last been updated 3 months ago. It gets updated sometimes, but it's anyone's guess if and when it would enter Godot. But even so, I would still like to check it out and see how it's going. So let's go click on the tests and try to download it. And no luck, the artifacts generated will only stay up for a few months. So as this feature didn't get any new updates lately, there are no files there we can download to test things out. Now, if you really want to check it out, there is still a way forward without having to compile Godot yourself. I won't go into too much details here, but you can fork Godot to your own GitHub, locally pull the branch of that feature and commit it to your own Godot fork. Your own copy of Godot also triggers GitHub actions. So when you push this branch to your own repository, it will create the action, and a few minutes later, you get a freshly baked artifact you can download. But that's it. I just wanted to showcase about this little known feature for those not involved with Godot DevOps. It is always cool to try out some of the new features before they are ready and get excited for the future. I hope you liked this video, and until next time.